5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Allora, la prima speaker di questa sera è una persona che mi fanno conoscere tutti, in realtà, e di questo mi sono molto grato, è una donna. Viene dalla California,
certo.
Vuoi dire qualcosa?
Allora, io lascerei poi che racconti se stessa perché lei è molto brava. Però Sara Cunningham ha fatto delle cose molto importanti, io lo so che è un piacere di averla come piacere, è un onore di averla come studentessa qualche anno fa, e le cose che fa sono molto interessanti, quindi ve la vi lascio ascoltare quello che ha da dire.
Sara Cunningham!
Pathways for stopping innovation, and people in different places and all over the world kind of came together to start integrating the things they had done. So Ben West had spent 5 years trying to communicate with a Medtronic insulin pump and eventually did. Dana Lewis and Scott LeBrand were writing an algorithm to continually adjust blood sugar data. And John Kostick, his son had diabetes and had a blood sugar sensor. So he was getting streaming blood sugar data, but then when his son went to school, he couldn't see what was going on. So he hacked the sensor so that he could see what was going on and make sure that his son was okay. So this is a drawing of the first artificial pancreas system that had gotten created, and it was a combination of a Raspberry Pi where the algorithm lived, the Medtronic insulin pump, a battery, the Dexcom receiver, which is the sensor receiver, and the Carolyn stick, which is the way that the data flowed from the Raspberry Pi back to the insulin pump. And I was fortunate enough to be involved with this community that got set up with that system. And it was about this big, and it was in my bag and always charging. And lots of other people started to hear about that system and were like, whoa, it is constantly adjusting. The thing that this did was constantly monitor and adjust the insulin delivery based on where your blood sugar was at that moment. Otherwise, you have a set rate of insulin, and that doesn't match up to what your body is doing. So as a person living with it, you're doing most of the work. So that was the first version of it. Then Nate Radcliffe started writing the iOS app and to integrate all of the different pieces along with Mark Wilson and many other people contributing to that code. Pete Schwamm had a daughter who wanted to use the system, but it was, like I said, in this bag about this big, and it was too big for her to carry around. And then Katie B. Simone also tried to do it, and she couldn't figure out how to set up the system. It was all on GitHub, and there was documentation, but she turned that documentation into something that many, many more people could understand. So she wrote all of Loop Docs, which is an entire instructions for how to set up your own system if you need it. And the system got much smaller. I now have my blood sugar and I'm able to deliver insulin from my watch. I carry around that Riley-like board, which is about this big, and I charge it at night with my phone. And that's really the only difference in the amount of things that I'm carrying day to day. And many, many more people could start to begin to use the system because of that. Along the way, the FDA had been in conversation with us in different ways. The FDA is the Federal the Food and Drug Administration in the U.S., which regulates all healthcare devices and other things. So that was a big advancement to have it get much smaller and be on my phone. That was another huge thing. So to carry around all of my data and be able to interact with it on my phone versus this pretty archaic, old school medical device made a huge difference as a young person living with type 1 diabetes. So, and along the way, the FDA has been involved, and the regulatory system was you had to basically, in order to get a system like this into the world commercially, it needed to be integrated into one thing, which caused a lot of, it was very slow to do that. And through the conversation with us, their regulatory system now has multiple pathways for different devices and has demanded that as the different medical device companies create different sensors and algorithms and pumps to do this, they can all go through different regulatory pathways, which basically speeds up the entire process of doing it. It opens the market for many more small companies to start participating in this in the world of diabetes technology. And that was because of people in the FDA and people at the device companies and people with diabetes communicating and working together to make this to basically speed up the system of innovation so that these devices got better. And we are a long way from where we were 10 years ago. So just to come back to the impact this made on people living with diabetes, it allows you basically to sleep through the night and to wake up without fear of dying overnight. And so my overall message is, yes, do it yourself, but also do it together. And, do it yourself, do it together, that is critical. And we've been talking a lot about human-centered design in the design world, and I would say it's moving towards human-led design, and that's what we're trying to do at HealthMade Design, which is the company that I run in the Bay Area.
Thank you. Thank you. Forse per nulla stai attento.